हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू बेसिक इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स वर्चुअल लेबोरेटरी। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द प्रैक्टिकल बाइपोलर जंक्शन ट्रांजिस्टर एज एन एम्पलीफायर। सो फॉर दिस क्लिक ऑन स्टडीज ऑन बीजेटी कॉमन एमिटर एम्पलीफायर। यू कैन रीड ऑल द थ्योरी रिलेटेड टू द एम्पलीफायर, बाईपास कैपेसिटर, ब्लॉकिंग कैपेसिटर, व्हाट इज अ फ्रीक्वेंसी रिस्पॉन्स कर्व, ऑल दिस थ्रू दिस थ्योरी सेक्शन। आई विल ब्रीफ ऑल दीज थिंग्स ड्यूरिंग द सिमुलेशन ऑफ द सर्किट डायग्राम। सो क्लिक ऑन सिमुलेशन एंड क्लिक ऑन कॉमन एमिटर एम्पलीफायर। टुडे वी आर ओनली सिमुलेटिंग the draw circuit diagram configuration or practical we will cover in some other tutorial. This is the circuit diagram of common emitter amplifier. The application of BJT is basically amplification. So as we all know that the amplification is the output is greater than the input parameter, means the output voltage is greater than input voltage. If we are talking in terms of current, then output current is greater than the input current. Now as we can see in the circuit diagram, there are so many resistors like RS, RB1, RB2, RE, RL, two or three capacitors like CC1, CC2 and CE. So we will discuss in brief that what is the requirement of all these resistances and capacitors in the schematic of the commutator amplification circuit. So let's start from the input portion, as we are interested to amplify a very weak signal whose magnitude is very small. So basically amplification is used for very small magnitude signals. So at the input terminal, input part, we are applying an AC signal that has some frequency across a resistance that is called RS, that is source resistance. Then it will pass through a CC1, that is coupling capacitor, then RB1 and RB2. So this is a configuration. RB1 and RB2, two resistances are used and they are biased through a voltage VCC. Output resistance, that is RC, collector resistance, and here RE, that is emitter resistance. This is our transistor that is in NPN configuration. Again a capacitor CC2, that is coupling capacitor number 2, second coupling capacitor. A bypass capacitor across emitter resistance or at the emitter terminal, that is CE, and at the last a load resistance across which we are taking our output. So basically the ratio of V0, that is our output voltage, to the input voltage that we are applying at the input terminal, it should be greater than 1. So for common emitter configuration, the amplification is very good in terms of voltage or in terms of current. That's why we prefer common emitter configuration for amplification purpose. Now what is the requirement of all these components, RS, CC1, RB1, RB2? So RS is basically a source resistance that is used to drop the voltage across it. So it is applied with the source. Coupling capacitor 1 is used basically block the DC component of the signal. RB1 and RB2, this is a potential divider configuration with the help of bias voltage VCC. And RB1 and RB2, we are basically providing a bias voltage to the input of this NPN configuration transistor. As we solved so many numericals in our theory portion with the help of potential divider biasing, then we calculate a Thevenin voltage, a equivalent resistor. So this is basically a potential divider configuration. Then collector resistance RC and emitter resistance RE. We have already the stabilization theory, like the Q point stabilization. So the role of RE is very important in the case of Q point stabilization, and CE capacitor, bypass capacitor, is used, as the name indicates, bypass is used for the stability of the circuit. All the current across the emitter terminal just pass through this common emitter, or you can say this bypass capacitor. It basically provides a low input impedance, means a low impedance value. The second coupling capacitor CC2 is basically again to block the DC component that are present in our signals, basically noise. And then load resistance RL is used to take the output from the collector terminal of the transistor. So for the simulation of the circuit, on the left hand side there is list of instruction. We have to set the value of source voltage to 50 millivolt and the frequency is 1 kHz. Keeping source voltage constant, we have to vary the frequency from 50 Hz in regular steps. We have to set the source resistance, collector resistance, emitter resistance, load resistance, RB1, RB2, then coupling capacitors CC1, CC2 to some value, bypass capacitor CE to 10 microfarad. Then the step 7 is click on add to table button to add the readings to the table. Then we have to change or vary the frequency by keeping the resistance constant, and then just click on plot button to plot magnitude graph of common emitter amplifier. Frequency is in x-axis and the magnitude, that is in dB, is in the y-axis. So let's start the implementation of or the simulation of this circuit. So you can set all the values of resistance and capacitor with the help of these sliding bars. In the instruction part, all the values of resistances and capacitors are given. We have to apply a signal V in that is of 50 millivolt and 1 kHz frequency. So next step is add this value to the experimental table. Now as we are drawing a curve between frequency and magnitude, so we have to change the value of frequency. Now set the value of frequency to some hertz, and then click on add to table. So we will take 8 to 10 values in our experimental table for different values of frequency. So increase some frequency to this. This is a graph between frequency and magnitude, that is in dB. So just remember that we are taking our magnitude in decibel. So this is our experimental table. Now the next task is to click on plot just click on plot. So this is a graph between magnitude and frequency for common emitter configuration. And in this graph we can see that here we are getting a flat band from this frequency to this particular frequency. So we can say that for this range of frequency, our amplifier, our BJT is working as an amplifier. On the right hand side, from this point, the values are continuously decreasing, and same here also the value is decreasing. So you can say, after analyzing the circuit or the frequency response curve, that this particular configuration for these particular values of resistances and capacitors, the BJT is working as an amplifier for this frequency range. So here the lowest cutoff frequency is 5 kHz and the high frequency is, I think, 2 MHz. So this is all about the simulation of common emitter amplifier circuit. Thank you.